The environmental movement is a war for the survival of humanity.
Paul Watson and his Sea Shepherd Society.
Paul Watson.
Paul Watson.
Captain Paul Watson.
The bad boy of the Canadian environmental movement.
I'll go to prison for as long as it takes.
These are a bunch of money-sucking manipulators.
If we're getting people annoyed, we're doing something right.
He's a professional radical ecologist.
What you'd call the Rambo of the environmental movement.
To many people, Paul Watson is simply a pirate on the high seas.
You only have vigilantes when there's an absence of law.
He was always the person who would go the farthest, be the most outrageous.
It's a world war, really, to save the whales.
I mean, you don't walk down the street and see a woman being raped and do nothing. You don't see a child being molested and do nothing. You don't see a kitten being stomped and do nothing. And you don't sit there and watch a whale die and take his picture and do nothing. And that's just cowardice.
Oh, my God. They did it?
People are going to get violent.
Paul was, like, out of control.
And it struck the Sierra full speed across the bow to damage the harpoon. The captain was trying to shoot at me.
Paul was voted off the board of Greenpeace Foundation.
The divorce from Greenpeace was a little bit messy, but I think in the end, it was exactly the right thing to happen. Paul went off and started the Sea Shepherd Society, and he got his own boat.
Greenpeace has just condemned you as a terrorist. What's your response? So I said, oh, what do you expect from the Avon ladies and the environmental movement anyway?
This is the Farley Vault. We're no protest ship. Now get out of here.
If anybody thinks they're going to change the world through appealing to the morality of human beings, then, you know, they're not going to get very far. You never retreat. You never surrender. You just keep pushing. And if we destroy the oceans, as we're doing, and the oceans die, then it's quite simple, we die. No oceans, no civilization, no humanity.